front. Zuccarello has Eriksson Ek. Got it through. They score! He fouled Hartman. And the Blues, Binnington coming after him. Hartman skated through Binnington's area and clipped him on the way by in celebration.
And Fleury's over there.
Come all the way down to drop the gloves.
My.
But the linesman has a hold of Binnington.
Oh, let him go. Holy jumping.
Marc-Andre Fleury trying to get at him, but the linesman won't let him.
Binnington taking exception after the goal by Hartman. He had a slight bump in. Binnington went at him right away while the Wild were celebrating. Marc-Andre Fleury with no hesitation at all. And Binnington wants this crowd going. Where's Ric Flair?
It is wrestling night here in St. Louis. The crowd is in the mood. Ryan Galloway and David Brisebois, the linesmen, are not. But I feel like this one is far from over.
Hartman does a great job. He strips the puck from Buchnevich, and then he gets the pass back. And now Watts right there. He's celebrating, one knee in the air, and Binnington's out of his grief. Binnington goes right at him and got a... Actually, he got a lot on him. I couldn't see that from my angle, but...
Scrap. Here we go. Evander Kane versus Brady Tkachuk. Wow.
Here we go. Right at the blue line. Couple left jabs. Tkachuk fires a straight right and an overhand right hook. Kane comes thundering back with a series of right hooks, and Tkachuk landed a right as well. Good tilt.
Spirited.
Kane all the way back. Now that's his first fight as an Edmonton Oiler.
And I think that's a big step for him, too. When you have an injury like he had to drop the gloves the first time, he's certainly been aggressive and physical, chippy. In the last couple of games, a little nick on the nose after that one. He got a couple right hands in early. And then Tkachuk was able to get back up and throw a couple shots himself. They had words earlier in the game, no question about it. You can see the neutral zone, the above your screen there. They kind of bump into one another, say, let's do this. And it was spirited, a couple good rights there. Brady goes down and then gets back up, and as Evander Kane is falling, he does get caught with a right hand going down. And always dangerous when your helmet comes off. Both guys were up, they were okay, and a very spirited scrap.
And you think maybe a con...
Tampa to the Buffalo line, but they'll go offside. Nice back checking there. And now we're going still in front. Jeannot.
Yep.
Welcome.
Tanner Jeannot and Stillman as well. Newcomers to each of their teams, and it's a heavy punch from Jeannot.
And Stillman. Calling for some help for Riley Stillman right now. Buffalo with a 3-1 lead on Tampa. A heated affair this afternoon.
Depending on how things break the next few weeks, first round playoff matchup. Shot slips it for Dewar. He gets bumped by Tanev, who gets wrangled down. And a penalty upcoming after the collision. And now some punches being thrown along the wall as Dewar throwing a wave of rights against Donato. Donato spills on top of him, and they will be separated early on here in the third.
Yeah, I don't know how comfortable Donato is in doing that, but Dewar is going to be the one that gets the initial two-minute penalty. Should be a hook or a hold on Brandon Tanev, against Brandon Tanev. So I suspect that it'll still be a power play here for the Kraken, and a real important one at that.
Seattle, number 9, 5 minutes for fighting. Minnesota, 26, 5 for fighting and 2 minutes for holding. Shorthand.
Yeah, so there it is. The extra 2 to Dewar for the initial infraction right here on Tanev. seem like much there. Thought maybe the left arm would have came over, but Donato, I think, trying to send a message to his group, right? I mean, this is, they're down 4-0. Brian Trent saw his teammate go into the wall a little hard, and let's see if that gives the Kraken a little bit of life. This is an important power play. They get one here, still lots of time.
You said it about Donato in a spot like that fighting. He keeps looking down at those knuckles on his right hand in that spot sitting in the box.
It's not something that he typically does, right? I mean, this is a guy that can score, but recognizing his team's down by 4, trying to provide a spark, and he does it without taking an extra 2. So let's see if the crowd.
Just trying to get one past Jonathan Quick of the Vegas Golden Knights, and now
we
got it going on again along the side boards. Maroon's in the middle of it. Perry's in there as well. Gloves come off, and Perry tackled down by Hague, and Bogosian's trying to pull Hague off of Perry. Maroon is trying to get in there as well. The linesmen have their hands full here. Acemon is also in a scrap in behind everything else.
Yeah, I can't see the Acemon one either because of the pile in front. They got those broken up. Referees don't normally get involved, but both linesmen are tied up with the dog pile just inside the blue line, and nobody is stopping. Everybody's got everybody by the shirt collar. Maroon is not stopping. Perry is not stopping. Houghton's in there. Hague is in there in the bottom of the pile somewhere. It started with the whistle, and then Maroon and Kolesar with a pop from a
out there along with Lindholm at center, and right now we're going to scrap Beaulieu.
Lucic out there and Beaulieu, and they drop him, and Beaulieu stepping up in weight class for this one. Lucic has been a leader on the ice, and he always handles himself well in that department.
Boy, does he ever. I didn't see this coming at all, but Nathan Beaulieu not afraid to step up. Obviously some words exchanged last game, and that was the tone that Jeff Ward wanted to start with, and here we go. Right out of the gates, they drop the gloves, and Lucic is just such a big, powerful guy for Beaulieu, trying to get a hold, throws a couple punches early, and then eventually Lucic will get that right hand loose. And always dangerous when he's freewheeling and swinging, throws a couple big bombs. But I like this response from Beaulieu, and I like the fact that Lucic right there didn't hit again. Listen, this is a rough sport and is fighting, but right there with a little respect to not hit him when he's down. But I like the energy brought out early here by Winnipeg.
2 seconds.
Left bomb against Lindholm. In deep, Zach Cassian gets bumped hard by you-know-who, Tkachuk. And Cassian's mad, and here we go. Now there's going to be penalties in the game. They've been going at each other on and off all night, and Zach Cassian is incensed.
Now, we showed earlier in the first period the one hit that knocked his helmet off, and I don't know if you could hear, but it was McDavid yelling at Cassian to have his head up because he saw, coming back from his point coverage, Tkachuk coming down, and I don't think you're necessarily going to see Tkachuk going into the penalty box. I think this is all going to be Cassian. Here's the play. I don't know. You can't see. He's coming down.
No,
Cassian.
Really,
no, and Cassian has the puck, so it's not like it's an interference call either. It's one of those hard hits that you're battling with one guy as Cassian's got Giordano. It looked like Cassian saw him at the last second, but his reaction was instant. McDavid comes in, and then the gloves come off, and he'd had enough with number 19.
Number 19 is still standing at the bench, and number 44 has gone to the dressing room inside of 2 minutes to go in the period. So he was coming down pretty fast, but he turned before the hit.
And right on cue, as we talked about the battle of Alberta, and here these two go at it hard, and Cassian's just throwing all of them.
And Jamie Benn, who's a tough customer, trying to get things going, him and Miles Wood getting together here, and let's see if something happens. Some fireworks. Both guys are very feisty. Ben can really handle himself from a fisticuff standpoint. And we've seen Miles Wood do it pretty well too, and here they go. And here they go, Ben and Miles Wood. And Ben's landing a lot of good ones. And Miles Wood lands one big right. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Oh, Ben early, Miles late. These guys, this is an old-style rock 'em, sock 'em kind of fight. That is two big boys throwing some heavy leather. Oh, baby, we don't see that too often anymore.
Kenny, he had three lower teeth knocked out after a high stick Sunday, and then 2 days later, a brawl with Jamie Benn.
That just shows the heart of Miles Wood. Up 3-0, he does not have to accept this challenge. Jamie Benn, well, the captain, the leader, trying to get his team going, get some kind of spark. These guys had words before the puck was dropped, and there they go, and Jamie Benn landed some heavy rights, then a left with his glove even on early on in this one. Look at Miles Wood. He does everything just to stay on his feet as Ben was really chucking him. But Miles Wood landed a couple of his own, and then he gets Ben down. They were swinging from the cheap seats. Both guys lost their balance because they were throwing them pretty heavy. Wow.
Right back around again, and a collision as the puck was not kept by Malkin. But now we have gloves coming off. Is Alexiak and Wilson. And Alexiak down, and Wilson will skate around and eventually go to the box.
Somebody better grab on Alexiak there. He was popped by Tom Wilson and going to need some help getting to the dressing room. And the first time that Tom Wilson sees the Pittsburgh Penguins since that hit back in the playoffs last year. Isn't on the ice more than 10 seconds.
And he took offense to a big hit earlier in the sequence. Good on Wilson for not continuing after he KOs Oleksiak right there. But that was all a byproduct of a big hit earlier in the sequence.
Playoffs last year, game three, Tom Wilson. On Aston Reese.
We got action here. Ovechkin and Crosby. Crosby says, why don't you fight him? Ovechkin says, why don't you fight me? Stop talking, he says. Well, it'll be fun tonight here.
We will pick up the penalty call or calls, and it may just be fighting majors, and it seems that that is the case, so no change in manpower.
Matthews off the end boards. Oh, McQuaid buries him. But Matthews is a big, strong boy, and he hops right up. Here's Spooner as they go end-to-end at TD Garden. Vetrano 2-on-1. The shot and a save by Anderson. McQuaid squares off with Matt Martin. Saturday night's all right for fighting. Two veteran pugilists who can really throw. Martin with a couple of quick jabs. Goes for a hook. McQuaid with a damaging blow, but Martin stays there. McQuaid with the left jab. Martin with another hook. McQuaid wild swinging blows. Knocks Martin's head off. Martin comes back at it. Martin connects with a big right. Just trading roundhouses out at the blue line. McQuaid goes to the ribs. He's got Martin leaking and down he goes. What a titanic tilt.
This is why Toronto has Matt Martin, the hit on ass Austin Matthews. Matthews is trying to get under the hit of McQuaid because he knows it's coming, hit nonetheless. And that's what gets Martin's attention. But he and McQuaid have had a running feud going all night long, and this was the time to do it. Both willing to do it. The Bruins had a quality scoring chance when this was starting to develop in the neutral zone. It was denied, but
stayed in it until that.
Ryan Reeves, here they go, Kane and Reeves.
And Kane are finally, after all that chirping, go after one.
Kane playing Reeves' game, though. Yeah, after Myers tough, the Ryan Reeves might be as tough as anyone in the NHL, but...
Wow! Haymakers!
And a little extra on the bottom.
Wow!
Evander Kane.
Haymakers being thrown between Ryan Reeves and Evander Kane.
And this has been building for three games, certainly longer than that. These two guys have a running dialogue, and we know Ryan Reeves to be one of the toughest fighters in the league. Evander Kane, 30-goal scorer, but can certainly do this. You gotta love the courage of Kane, the toughness of Reeves, and the response of both benches. This was a heavyweight tilt.
Pitcher dropping off. Full Horvat with a shot, the glove saved by Stala. And now Foligno comes in because McEwen was in the goaltender's face after the save, and they've dropped the gloves. Zach McEwen and Marcus Foligno. There's a big right from Foligno and another one. Man, are they trading?
Yes.
I don't think McEwen really made contact with goaltender Stalock. He just skated up and stood in front of him. And Foligno took issue to that. And he's trying to pump them up here at XL Energy Center. Looks like McEwen landed one on the forehead as things liven up in St. Paul.
Trouble in front. Kerfoot can't come up with it, and we've got a penalty, a cross check, and Wayne Simmons dropped his gloves with Ben Chiarot.
And that's a direct result of the end of that last other shift where you've got Gallagher at the one end. Now you can see Simmons motioning not to the Montreal bench to hit. Okay, maybe I can make some sort of emotional difference. What a play there, this little spinorama by Matthews is Price able to find that one through the legs of his own defender. And here's the battle. This is a bit of the old time battle. You're not often you're able to get away with one, two, or three cross checks. I think they were both getting away with one each, and then now the arm went up and the gloves went down.
Toronto, Montreal, Hamilton, Scarborough. And
for the Blackhawks, there's a hard hit. Brendan Lemieux says hello to Reese Johnson. And we're going to have some gloves dropped. It's Lemieux and Jujhar Khera.
Khera wanted to go. Lemieux wasn't ready. And let's give Khera a little bit of credit. He waited until Lemieux was able to square off and drop his gloves. Of course, Brendan's not going to back off from this type of situation.
They both want to free themselves from this. They're in a tangle.
They're pretty good scrappers, of course, both of them. So they have technique to this. It's not just throw. It's where you're grabbing. It's where you're holding on. Can you get free? When you throw, do you expose yourself? A whole bunch of things going on in this circumstance. But this is early on, first period. See the linesman, communication. Both guys understand that they were really good defensively. The jiu-jitsu battle was going on right there. Who can grab, who can hold, who can get it open. They couldn't get down to the ice, but it's still, that tires you out. When you have a wrestling match like that, you're dead tired.
This will not go in an art museum, this fight.
You see the contact right there. That's from the side, no problem. Entwistle, no, excuse me, that was Reese Johnson. I don't think there's any problem with that initial contact. It came onto the right shoulder of Johnson. The car comes across, right? So then they're talking things over, the officials are right now. And they're talking things over. Now they're talking with the captains on each team, or at least the assistant captain with the Kings, and the captain, Jonathan Toews. Couple of things going on here. The car come over and have a little bit, that instigation, meaning did he leave his position to get involved in the scrap as opposed to just joining the play? I think that's going to be the call. We'll hear it right here.
He's off and running.
And now we drop the gloves. Foligno for Minnesota, Brendan Dillon for the Jets. St.
Second fight this season for Foligno. Ooh, a couple of solid shots in this one. A heavyweight bout, to say the least, that started with a pretty interesting jump move for Foligno.
Oh. He's fired up. Dylan, a tough customer, Anthony, but I tell you what, Marcus Foligno is so effective at fighting because I think it sneaks up on people how long he is. He's got long arms, such good reach. And you look, Dylan can't reach him, but every one of Marcus's are connecting on the head. He's long, he's strong, and when he gets upset like that, he's fired up. He's ready to go. Man, he can change the complexion of a game in a hurry, can't he?
Well, this place has been buzzing all night.
To teach at the Barry Melrose Summer Camp, and right away we have a fight. Zach McEwen, Matt Martin, 17 against 17. We told you there would be carryover, and here it is. Two big rights.
Ooh.
Matt Martin.
Oh, steady rights.
McEwen hanging in there, not looking for the tackle, and he has it. So there it is, 7 seconds in. We mentioned the 46th penalty minutes in the third period over the weekend on Long Island, and right from the get-go, we take care of things.
Gritty approving of it as well. So too are the faithful that are here in the building at Wells Fargo Center. Heavyweight tilt to start this one off, Bucci.
Mm. Matt Martin.
Here comes the calls.
Philadelphia number 17, New York number 17, both players each 5 minutes for fighting.
Zach McEwen, Matt Martin, 33, game number 840, and two big fellas going toe-to-toe.
Two big heavyweights going toe-to-toe, and they were wide open, too.
Wasn't very much. Oh, round two.
One. Round two.
Delorier, he can chuck them, we know that. And in the lineup tonight, for this reason, Ross Johnston.
Whoa.
So right at the same face-off dot, both bouts just outside the Islander end. Who's going to throw the first one here?
A lot more gamesmanship.
Oh, big right from Delorier early.
He connected on that one. Square and flush.
Oh, good right from Johnston there.
Nice counter. This one a little more tactical. It hasn't opened up yet, and now it will on the glass. There it is.
Johnson lost his helmet. Doing well for the Islanders right now.
Delorier getting in some short noogies there, too.
Delorier leads the NHL in penalty minutes and majors, so he'll add five more. His knuckles bleeding already. So 1 second after the Martin and McEwen fight, it's Delorier and Ross Johnston.
That was the second one on the card, so to speak.
You know, Jody, he really is. He is. He's when you talk to him, there's a lot of detail, the way he works. Ooh, here we go.
But Branson didn't like that push and shove and went right back of that flyer in front of the bench. And we got quite a set two going here.
That's Konechny in there. He's the guy that get under the skin. He's not the biggest guy. He's got some fire now that the linesman's there. But Branson, you're right. Didn't like what happened. He took it out on Travis Konechny. Let's see here if we can see it.
Little push.
There's another little one.
Ask and ye shall receive.
Look at Delorier barking on the bench.
Number 11, Columbus Valley number 44, two each.
That's the right call there. Even it up. Good to have a guy like this in your roster, JD. I mean, you picked him up last year, and he understands his
role. Absolutely. I mean, he also, I think, makes the bench feel a lot better.
Oh, yeah.
He's not afraid to talk to the other team's players and keep the balance. Okay, Jody, we've seen a really fast pace. How's it going to be here with the 4-on-4?
It's going to be wide open, don't you think? Fantilli's over the boards.
Yeah, it could be entertaining.
You've got Texier out there.
There's another one that came back after not playing over here all last season. He's had a good camp, too. He's gotten bigger. It looks like he went from a young man to a grown-up man.
He's back on his skates. Here's Montour in front on the backhand. Goes wide. Bennett went right to that Panther bench. He got tagged pretty good. Sorelli chips it ahead. Yeah, they're going at it in behind the play. That's Joseph and Ryan Lomberg, or Shen, rather. So Shen and Lomberg throwing them.
Well, Shen got in a couple of early ones here in the early part of this little altercation, and Lomberg comes back. And then later on in that shift, you'll see Lomberg come right after Luke Shen, drop the gloves, and away they go. That was the response to the hit. And Lomberg finds out very quickly that Luke Shen is a lefty.
Got across, and then Ennis taken it hard by Romanoff, and he takes the hit from Cassian. And we got a fight early on. Anderson,
Lagesson,
and Lagesson.
I did not know this was part of Lagesson's game. They must have had something going in the corner. And Josh Anderson, a rare decision to get going up 2-0 here, but obviously something happened to spark this one.
And if you're a Montreal Canadiens fan, you just don't want anyone getting hurt on both sides, obviously, for the Oilers and the Habs. You think of Ben Chiarot right now, and Anderson, the right hand, and he knocked him. And let's hope that Lagesson.
And at the end of the shift, Marner will work it ahead. Morgan Rielly just drops it down as the Leafs are in the midst of a change. Shots are 7-5 Montreal as we approach the midway mark of this first period. Over than ahead, now shoveled in by the goal scorer Evans. Klingberg shoulder to shoulder with Harvey Pinard. Jake McCabe up with it, up ahead center, and dropped down the ice by Gregor. Ryan Reeves on the forecheck, and here's the first Richter scale hit, and the West can't be surprised by this. Arbor Jack Eye, Ryan Reeves, first ever meeting between these two teams in a regular season game.
Well, the youngster with a little message sending there. And Reeves made a hit earlier on in this shift. They got the crowd into it. And I think everybody in the building knew when that puck was going along the boards and Dooley was trying to make a play, that Dooley was going to get hit. No head guy, though, 101 penalty minutes last year. Here's the first hard hit that got the people on the edge. Now the second one, and no hesitation. Reeves gets up. Jack Eye's already got the gloves down, and away they go.
That comes from Mayfield. Mayfield racing for impact. Takes a couple of cross checks there as they're trying to get him to go. Lawson Crouse wants to go with Mayfield, and he will oblige. Lawson Crouse, and he came right after Mayfield with a series of cross checks, and then Mayfield lands an uppercut as Crouse went down to the ice.
Mayfield never had his gloves off and was still had hold of his one stick as Crouse was cross checked him three or four times and really basically forced Mayfield into a fight and either slow to get off his gloves. There's the good hard check. 1, 2, 3, and then, okay, now, okay, do you want to go?
Number 24.
And you can just see
Arizona,
the stick
number 67.
Caught up in the area.
Both guys got 5 minutes each for fighting.
And then watch the right and then come back in an uppercut right there. And that one probably hurt a little bit, but Scott Mayfield a little slow to start on that altercation, but strong.
As Rowney plays it back and passes it right through his own goal crease. Backus is hit hard by Clifford. Puck picked up by Rowney, makes a move, he's in, and now behind the play, Delorier jumps in, and he and Clifford are going to go.
Well, Delorier did not like the hit on David Backus, and that's why he goes after Kyle Clifford. And right after the scrap, Delorier turns to Backus and just says, "You all right?" A good teammate. It was Kyle Clifford that got a real good hit in on David Backus, and that was all shoulder. Clean hit, but Delorier took exception to it, and he chased down Kyle Clifford. And you know Kyle Clifford is always a willing combatant. Kind of honors the code, stands up. They have a good scrap, a little pass, and hey, good scrap.
Clifton, left point, Gergensen's who's taking another shift as a defenseman. He threw that one on goal, and Benson's not done in front with Corona. And we may have more and more of this as the afternoon progresses. A
a late takedown there. It's Hronek who was initially pushed at that front of the net fracas from Zach Benson. He's now up and out of it, but you're right, this game's going to deteriorate. And got to keep your head up, especially that defenseman, Hughes. Given that Buffalo was already down three defensemen, we'll get into the front of the net, little D to D, and thrown there. Swatted out
Buffalo
by Benson,
12,
and then
Vancouver
you've
number
got
17 each have 2 minutes for roughing.
Battling to clear the front of the net.
By the sounds of it, Benson didn't get anything, but Greenway did, along with Corona.
Yeah, Greenway got into it, putting down Hughes. So we'll get back to 4-on-4, which was what we had in the first 5 minutes of this second period. I mean, remember the very first shift of the hockey game when Peterka was trying to forecheck and he got kind of nudged into the boards by Hronek, and a couple of shifts after that, you had a Hronek on Samuelson. Again, incidental contact, but Samuelson's left the game.
Own goal. That's where you go back to your basics. Oh, here we go.
Here we go. This is Pat Maroon and Austin Watson dropping the gloves right off the faceoff. Maroon's got the left rabbit punches going, and now Watson steadies things down. He's got his rights free, and in comes Maroon.
Pat Maroon's a very good technical fighter. Watson's more like a mayhem fighter. But you can land some big ones for sure. Patty's cut, or somebody's cut. Yeah, I think he got him somehow. Watson got him because Pat's nose is cut. They have the visors on, of course. They get that left arm locked out. They're both righties. But yeah, I think Watson got a pretty good 1-2 punch in there early on. So 5 minutes each. They talked about it off the faceoff. I had a feeling this probably might happen. Yeah, right off the faceoff. Let's see where the first blow comes right there. That first one was pretty darn good right there. I think that was the one that got Pat bleeding right there. Watson technically really good there too. He tried even a body shot there, holding them off. You keep your head away, wait for your open. Yeah, we'd have to give the edge there to Watson. Good job.
Gloves have been dropped. Middleton dropping the gloves with Dillon. This almost certainly has to do with Dillon's cross-check to the back of Kaprizov. Middleton's landed a couple pretty good ones early in this fight. A
couple big rights. Middleton's got him with range. I think the longs are a little longer for Middleton, so he's got there. Dillon trying to extend Middleton, but can't. But a good fight as the referees come in. Middleton without a helmet. Referees, say linesmen, come in to stop it when it's safe for the linesmen, prevent head injuries. But good bout between these two. I mean, you got Jake Middleton answering the bell, going out there. Sir Dillon knows that you can't be doing that to 97.
Minnesota five.
Dillon
five
accepts. Tight game. Knowing that they play each other tomorrow. Middleton with a couple of fakes. Yeah, this is a good hold from Middleton, and he got off to a good start to this one. Dillon has been a thorn in the wild side for years. You go back this history with Marcus Foligno a couple years ago, the Superman punch.
No power play results from this fight. Still 5-on-5, just over 5 minutes into the third period.
Taking a shorthanded goal. Here's Radish's long shot, saved by Bobrovsky. They battle for the rebound. Stamkos up, and then he's barking, and now Stamkos is taking it up towards him, and he's going to try to take Sony with him, and he drops the gloves with that pad, and down the day go.
Steven Stamkos is hot. He thought he got hit illegally. He flipped his stick around on Ekblad, caught him up in the face, and then they both glared at each other and jumped at him. It'll be interesting to see what the penalties are here. power plays being what they are, one goal game being what it is, this is big.
They were going to make the announcement, but they're going to talk it over for a moment. So you know what? We'll let them sort it out, and we will tell you about it. Come back. Just another chapter in the Sunshine State Showdown going on here tonight. 5:37 to go.
The Steven Stamkos is hot. Ekblad is in there. Watson's been in, so Stammer must have got an extra one. He thought there was a should have been a penalty on that one, likely for interference or a cross-check. He's mad at Ekblad, so he slapped him with the stick, caught him up high, came in on him there. Ekblad fighting with them, and we haven't heard the announcement yet.
Foligno jams it around the boards. Maroon. Ruzicka up high on a reverse hit. Then Maroon catches a stick in the chops.
Yeah, Ruzicka, he's heading to the bench right now. We got a scrap.
Foligno drops the gloves for Minnesota against Greer for Calgary.
Marcus Foligno caught Greer with a real good one right there. Hang on, kid. The takedown there by A.J. Greer, but that Greer jumping in there against Foligno. Pretty brave soul there. Eighth-year pro A.J. Green's been up and down from the American Hockey League, claimed off of waivers earlier, but it is. This all started from a puck that was placed from the defensive zone and all the way down the ice. And then there's your hit. Something must have happened before that to trigger that. I think that kind of surprised Marcus Foligno that this kid wanted to scrap. That one right there hit him right on the button. That was the one I was talking about. He didn't feel the effect of that until about a second and a half later. And takedown, but Marcus Foligno won nothing.
Plus, he has a goal in the game, so it's 2-0.
Well, we're two-thirds of the way to the Gordie Howe hat trick there for Marcus Foligno.
Ekblad. Verhaeghe turns. He shoots wide. Barkov in behind one more time. Good push by Florida. Forsling shoots. Stopped. And we get the whistle. Oh, and then the traffic in front. And here goes Reinhardt against Dillon. Dillon throwing some punches against Reinhardt.
Dillon's one of those toughest guys in the league right there. Give Reinhardt credit. He went right after him and stood up to the big, tall defenseman. Panthers try to crowd that front of the net. Reinhardt stood there and took the punishment. Officials discussing this. Here's the pressure. There's the original shot. The battle out in front. Reinhardt gets a stick and the gloves up with Dillon. Then they drop it. And there is the fight.
Long discussion here.
Florida 13. Winnipeg 5. 5 minutes each for fighting. Florida 23. Minor penalty. Grabbing the face mask. Winnipeg, number 4, 2 minutes roughing. We're playing 4-on-4.
All right, so everything evens out. They got a couple of minors there on Verhaeghe and Pionk in addition to the fight.
On the other defenseman in there, get those loose pucks. Don't just throw them in and let them get them out.
And now right off the draw, Goodrow and Duhaime throw down the mitts. They wanted to go just before we left for commercial break. And this fight went to the ice. They're back up to continue the bout.
Goodrow had a pretty good grab on him right off the beginning. I don't think Duhaime got hit with much, but he did get a few off the helmet. And with those two guys, you know, Goodrow is their most physical forward on that team, and Duhaime constantly, you know, provides that for the Wild. So it's something that, you know, you wouldn't be surprised to see happen. See him bounce right back there, but Goodrow's throwing, but he's not really getting anything up to that point. It looks like
you know, Duhaime just lost balance there. But, you know, that gets the blood going. It gets the Wild, I'm sure, into a more physical mode right now. Have guys that will provide that for your team. So I expect this game is going to get more physical as we go along.
And there's a big hit by Coles. He steps into Jankowski, and Bennett goes after Cole and starts throwing right hands. Sam Bennett immediately steps in for his teammate. Jankowski is back on his feet. And you can see that hit coming as Cole came all the way across the ice. And the fans like what Bennett does, defending his teammate.
And you're right, Rick. We could see this whole play developing, and Cole read it as well. Jankowski going down the tunnel also. Suicide pass right there, and Cole knew it right away. Also, he dropped his gloves knowing that Bennett's coming after him. Boy, Sam Bennett, that's a good fight. It wasn't a high hit, though. Didn't leave his feet, didn't launch himself.
Mark Giordano said Sam Bennett went, told him this a while ago, sneaky yep. tough. Oh.
Held in by Chychrun. McEwen takes contact as he got clipped by Pezzetta, and Harris collects the puck. Harris flips it to space in the corner, and the gloves come off, and you saw this coming. McEwen, Pezzetta, spurred off at center ice here in Ottawa. McEwen looking to get the left going. Pezzetta sets up. Pezzetta right hand gets the rights going, and then a takedown. Michael Pezzetta at center ice. Number 55 is all fired up tonight in the nation's capital.
Looking to make a hit like he does a lot, and Zach McEwen takes exception to that. And I don't have a problem with the hit. I don't have a problem with the response. I think if you're two players that are willing to go, you don't like that someone takes a run at you. Pezzetta could have got McEwen's knee. McEwen got out of the way, and both players to fighting. And it was a really good fight. Got the crowd going as a minute and 2 seconds left in a pretty spirited first period. I like the half.
And it's brought along and out of the zone. And here comes Dumba and Brady Tkachuk. And they're going to go in behind the play.
Oh, boy.
They're going to get it going here. Let's see. This is Matt Dumba's first fight as a Coyote.
Oh, Brady Tkachuk, he's one tough dude. He's throwing bombs right now. And not only Brady Tkachuk, happy with that one. He wanted a couple more whacks at him. Well, that's what Brady Tkachuk is all about. After the big hit by Dumba, who's been real physical the last three or four games, which we love. There's the hit.
Arizona number 24, Ottawa number 7, both 5 minutes each for fighting.
Sends Tkachuk to the ice, and Tkachuk called on Matt Dumba from his back, and Dumba obliges. Love everything about it. Crowd here at the Mullet loves it. Brady Tkachuk, he's just so rangy. Big dude, those big long arms.
See this. Uh-oh. Ryan Reeves drops him for the first time this season with Minnesota against Nicholas Deslauriers. Who else?
Wow. Buckle up. These are two heavies.
Reeves took the first few swings, sizing up Deslauriers.
Yes.
And Reeves goes on the offensive with a flurry of rights.
Two tough customers, long and rangy too. Both jostling at this point.
Reeves.
Tactical bout.
Lance O'Reilly tries an uppercut on Deslauriers.
Grabbed by the jersey. 40 seconds in already.
Savard intercepts Komisar's outlet, looking for Lucic. Lukanic rides him off.
Kostets and Plekanec. Here we go. Komisarek has been begging to go with Lucic. Lucic under. Cracks him with the right. Lucic gets him in the air. Turtles. Komisarek down. And Lucic taunts the Montreal bench. They have beaten them. And tonight they have beaten them up.
Well, I don't know if he was taunting the bench, Jack. I think he was just turned to the crowd to get the crowd in. This has been percolating for better than a year, these two players, Komisarek and Lucic.
It's a madhouse here.
Well, the Bruins are really trying to establish something here at home. They've won four straight. They've done it in a different number of ways, but the one constant is they're tough to play against. And that doesn't mean necessarily fighting, Jack. It means taking hits to make plays, taking the body when it's there, being
Gensel offside. Very close at the line, and now it's Crosby behind the play with Konechny. As TK has obviously got under Crosby's skin.
You haven't seen that for a while. Good to see as Konechny's going after Crosby there. Still on the ground. Crosby pushing the helmet of Konechny into the ice.
For a while, it looked like they were playing Twister. They just got all tangled up, but TK didn't want to let go, did he?
It's the pile driver right there. Yeah. A little WWE going, and then Crosby eventually took exception to that. He's going to do a pile drive of his own. Two of them. And then pushing the back of the helmet down. That's when the shield starts to hit you right in the face.
Yeah, Six sees the highlights. Wilson.
Yeah.
Hit the Bush David.
Copycat moment.
Right out of the box. Wilson with a right. His helmet is off. They're throwing rights. Wilson and trying to come back is Coburn. Wilson throwing a right and then Coburn. The helmets are off.
He's keeled over right now, going to the bench, paying the price.
And now Lucic is going after Borowiecki. And they'll drop the gloves. Borowiecki throwing right hands furiously. Now Lucic, an overhand right connects. And down they go.
Those are two tough men there. Lucic lets up at the end there out of respect for Borowiecki, but two tough customers going toe-to-toe. Watch the front of the net here. Right there, battle. They talk about it. They're talking about it. They agree, let's go. Lucic dropped him first. Trying to get the edge. And right there, but look at these, both of these guys connected. Oh, Boro connects with a big one there. Another one, then he loses his balance and he got caught. And then right here, Lucic stops and you gotta respect that. Respect for your, you give it all. In a fair circumstance there. Geez, there are some haymakers being thrown by those two. Wow.
Well, the intensity level has just shot up in this period. Two fights. Borowiecki.
On the outside of the net, and Elliott will stop that at the side of the goal and hang on. And more rush stuff after the whistle. Well, we thought this game might have a playoff feel, and it does. Now the gloves are off. Ferland, oh, lands a big right hand. As he dropped the mitts with Watson, who gets back to his feet. Second fight in this period.
Give the big Watson lots of credit. He bounced right up after that shot from Ferland. A rough game, and we've seen a lot of guys with a lot of enthusiasm here, a lot of drive. I just love this kind of stuff, and it's really brought up the temperature here in the building.
And he sets in for the faceoff against Sean Corral.
Oh, here we go, yep. Brown.
And we're going to go. Yep, it's going to be Gabranson and Brown right off the faceoff.
Oh, boy. Two big boys. We haven't seen this all that much. A big square off here at the mullet.
And Gabranson probably trying to get his team going. And
chucking them. They're chucking them. An old-fashioned punch in the face contest here at the Moulet. Brown connects.
They popped the helmet off as well.
Oh, yeah. coming from downtown.
I got to tell you, it's a little bit different watching from 13 rows up, Tyson.
Well, now you get a little bit of a closer look. Both guys giving them, both guys taking them. This is old school right here. Wow.
To choose from more forwards than defensemen, and that is why things are a little bit tenuous in the back end. How about this? Right as we get underway, it is McDermott and Delorier round three.
So obviously this was understood before the drop of the puck. You can kind of tell that both guys know each other so well that they initially take that stance, but then adrenaline takes over. And then the technique goes out the window. Big right there by McDermott. And both guys, both benches, both teams. We've seen these before from these guys. They end up being marathons. I'm talking about all night long. And then you see the linesmen.
And the Ducks this season, McDermott and Delorier come to blows again.
There now, and again, the teal wall at the line.
Yes, there is. You're right. Interference in the neutral zone. Connor McDavid got dropped in the neutral zone. And they should be going after him here.
And it is Cassian against Hurdle.
This is going to get nasty here.
Manning and Goodrow. Manning dropped his gloves and they will. Now, Manning. Left hands, two of them. Goodrow coming back with some uppercuts, and then he wants the takedown. He'll get it, but Manning's not done yet. And finally, the linesman get in there. But Manning landed a couple of good left hands early in that one, and then Goodrow came back with some uppercuts. But the temperature is rising here at the SAP Center in San Jose.
This is what started it all. A interference hit from Tomas Hertl, rather cheap away from the play, and this is what ticked everybody off. And Barkley Goodrow had to fight his line mate's battles.
We'll be back to sort it out. Rogers Oilers Hockey here on Sportsnet.
Dubois for Kopp, across the Oilers to Kopp, in shoots, that reflected wide off the stick of Sandin. Scooped up by Ehlers. Matthews in a battle in the corner with Dubois. They're still spinning. And meanwhile, the puck moves up the ice. Spezza drops it off to Bunting.
Eventually, they got to blow the whistle here. This is a flat-out wrestling match down in the corner.
And they finally did. That was happening 200 feet away from the puck.
For 10 seconds. I'm thinking what's happening here is the official's not sure who to call the penalty on. It could be for Matthews for holding and Dubois for roughing. So he lets it roll. Then eventually it just continued. You got to blow the whistle and separate them.
Here with 4.5 gone in the third.
So here's the battle starts in the corner. Now they're tied up. So Dubois is trying to get his stick out, but now he's clearly roughing Matthews. I mean, that's a penalty there somewhere. And the official's 1.5 away. So out of all of this, I believe they're each going to get 2 minutes.
Yes. And the quizzical look of Sheldon Keefe.
Probably not sure what to think. That was a holding penalty on Matthews to start. Then it was clearly roughing on Dubois. Past that, I'm not sure what you call it, so that's what you have. Each of you go get a drink of water, and we'll sit there for 2 minutes.
So it's 4-on-4 here. 4.5 gone in the third period. Tavares, Nylander, Brody, and Riley for Toronto. And off the faceoff, Tavares trying to kick that free. Racing ahead is Brody. TJ Brody shoots. That goes just wide. Not picked up by Riley.
Instead, the other direction. McKenzie to Bork into the zone for Stankoven.
Stankoven looking for help. Lost the puck. Oh, he's hammered by Baddock. Up high. The Stars are going to go after Baddock there. Curtis McKenzie will tackle him, but Logan Stankoven took a high hit from Baddock, and it was going to be the first power play the Stars would get in the weekend. But I don't know that it'll stay that way, because Curtis McKenzie went barreling in on Baddock to make him pay for that one. 8:28 to go in the second period. Well, when you try to crush one of the league's best players, that's what happens afterwards. Baddock, known for playing the physical brand, and that time definitely went over the line, and then the Stars took exception. Bork and McKenzie went after him. We'll see what comes of this. Yeah, Baddock, I think, got the worst of it when it was all said and done from the looks of those images as he was helped down the tunnel. So this might take some time to sort out. It's a little bit of a yard sale at the moment with sticks, gloves, helmets on the ice, and they'll probably have to bring the ice crew out with shovels because the aftermath of that. Quite a bit of blood over there by the...
Panthers control. Here's Montour to the far circle. Back out. 10 seconds. Lundholm fires. It's blocked. That's got to be a broken stick. A 5 second. Save made by Hill. Bennett looking for the puck. Puts out in front. Oh! It's all over. Panthers come that close to sending this game to overtime. Win it 3-2.
And a mad scramble here at the end, guys. Bennett and Carlson down on the ice. Tkachuk and Petrangelo, who came out on the penalty box, are involved as well.
If you're Matthew Tkachuk, you got to be awfully careful here. Fans throwing water bottles on the ice. This is embarrassing right now. Matthew Tkachuk had an unbelievable opportunity with a couple of seconds remaining in this game. And Angel got a piece of it or not. Zach Whiteclaw breaks a stick. Now all head breaks loose. But watch him in front of the net. Too white. The puck's going to work itself back to the front of the net. He has no stick. And Tkachuk has it. And Hill stops that with his left pad. Oh! Maybe McNabb got a piece of it before it got to the pad. Oh, my goodness. What a stop at the end of game four. And then all heck breaks loose. You had a wrestling match in
between. Sunday, yes, we did.
There could be fireworks at Amerley.
4-1 Washington. Still 5:40 to go.